VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP may be the original lookup functions that were introduced in Microsoft Excel. But now, there's newer and better available with XLOOKUP. What's great about XLOOKUP is you can look up values in either direction, and as we'll soon see, we can even look up values in both directions with the right formula structure. XLOOKUP is a newer function that was introduced in 2020 and is only available to those using the 2021 version and on of Microsoft Excel, or those who have a Microsoft 365 license. Okay, let's see how we can use this function to look up our values. Here I have a profit and loss. I can understand various items in my business, such as my revenue, cost of goods sold, and operating expenses. Let's develop a lookup function using XLOOKUP to find a value in Q2 2023 for whichever metric I want to include. To start, I've created a dropdown for each metric in my profit and loss over here. I'll select gross profit. Okay, now let's start populating the formula. I'll hit equal XLOOKUP, open parentheses. Now I'm being asked for my lookup value. That lookup value would be whatever I have selected from my dropdown, in this case, gross profit. I'll hit comma. Now I'm being asked for my lookup array. And here's what I love about XLOOKUP. I'm just going to highlight the column that contains my lookup value as such. Now I'll hit comma again. For my next argument, I'm being asked to specify my return array. This is where I want my corresponding value to output. In this case, it's going to be Q3 2023's column over here. Now I can close my parentheses and hit enter. And as you can see, the value for gross profit populates as such. Man, that was so easy. But there's actually more to the function, which I can access via these optional arguments over here. So let's say I enter in the value cash, which is a balance sheet item, as my lookup value in this range. If I hit enter, it'll show a scary NA error. Man, that haunts my nightmares. Let's make the experience here a bit more friendly by adding a message saying not found. Ah, much better. I'll go ahead and undo that to get back to our original example with gross profit. We can now continue by providing a match mode. Here, I have more options over what I have traditionally with VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. I'm going to go ahead and choose an exact match by entering 0. I'll hit comma again. And now this last optional argument is for the search mode. This is a bit more advanced of a topic, so we won't go into it in detail. But for context, it allows you to specify how exactly Excel will search this range to find the lookup value. If your data is sorted, Excel will spend less time iterating through your dataset by stopping its calculations once the value is found. This is especially useful if you have a large dataset and want to save on processing power. I'll go ahead and hit 1 to search first to last. And now I'll hit enter. Great! Our XLOOKUP function is working. I can go ahead and change the metric, and the value will update. But what if I wanted to look up these values horizontally instead? Well, I can repeat these same steps, only this time with horizontal ranges. I'll navigate to this tab over here, and I'll select my lookup value. This time, my lookup value corresponds to the headers that I have in each column as such. I'm going to select Q4 2023. So I'll type in equals XLOOKUP, open parentheses, and I'll point to my lookup value of Q4 2023. Now for my lookup array, I'm going to go ahead and highlight the row where my lookup value is contained as such. I'll hit comma, and now I'm being asked for my return array. In this case, I want to return the values for gross profit for whatever period is shown over here. So I'll go ahead and highlight the row for gross profit as such. I'll then close my parentheses, and if I hit enter, you'll see that my value populates. This is one of my favorite aspects about XLOOKUP. It's so flexible.